Okay, here I am, backstage, Reading 2009. Thank goodness the sun is shining. It was raining not that long ago. Now, I'm here with a member of the Friendly Fires, and which is why I've brought these, because having seen you in lots of interviews, Ed, I know you like a tipple, so can I offer you one?
Yeah, you certainly can. Thank you very much.
Well, look, let me crack it open, or at least get it for you. There you go, mate.
Thank you so much, mate.
My pleasure. So anyway, how are you doing?
I'm okay, yeah. We just got back from America yesterday afternoon, so I should be jet lagged, but...
Is it not kicked in yet?
No, I actually had a good old kip last night, so I'm feeling fine for now.
You're feeling fine. It's been a whirlwind year for you guys, hasn't it?
It has. It's been a busy, busy year. We've had two world tickets where you get to stop off in like a week around wherever you can. So that feels, yeah, ridiculous to be able to say something like that.
And you're not stopping here long, are you? You're disappearing off tomorrow.
We're disappearing tonight. We're going to Creamfields tomorrow and then obviously Leeds on Sunday.
Now you're up on the NME stage this year. That's right, isn't
that's
it?
Right, yeah.
How long till you're up now? How long till you're on?
We're on at 7:50, so I don't know what the time is now, but judging by the sun, I'd say we've got about 6 hours of interviews before.
Are you good at telling, the time from the sun?
If it's right above you, it's about 12 o'clock.
Is that so right?
That's what I make up.
That's impressively made up. Now, nominated for the Mercury Prize, that's got to be a real boon for you guys. You must be chuffed.
Yeah, it's fantastic. I mean, we didn't really see it coming at all because our album came out on the cusp of the last award ceremony, and to be frank, I don't know, we just didn't have a clue that we'd be kind of honoured like that. So, yeah, it's amazing.
And obviously you played here last year. And is it nice to be able to sort of chart your progress, to look back and see how far you've come since then? Because you played sort of middle of the day then, didn't you?
Yeah, exactly. It is odd because you kind of, I don't know, we're almost taking it in our stride that we've got to this level, which is, I don't know, arrogant perhaps, but it's just odd when it happens day to day. It's a kind of gradual build-up. But when you get a festival like this and you can think, yeah, this time last year we were at a totally different position. Yeah, it's times like that you actually step back and think, fuck, it's going really well.
How's that beer slipping down?
It's all right.
Now, I've watched loads of interviews with you guys. Now, I know you got together when you were 14, school in St Albans, and you seem as chummy as any band out there. Is that genuine? You all like three of your best mates?
Yeah, well, I think we're pretty much friends as soon as we were in a band together. I don't think there was much gap before that whatsoever. It makes all the difference as well. I don't really know how you could be so close with people, like live so much of your life with them and not actually be good mates with them.
There's no danger, for example, of you going through perhaps what like the Stone Roses went through quite famously here at Reading and having a tiff somewhere down the line and going your separate ways.
I know, it's only been one album so far. There's plenty of time for it to kick off, yeah.
Now, an interesting thing about your band, or rather one member of your band, I have to talk about Ed Macfarlane, your front man. I was at a party the other week, and we put one of your tracks on, Paris, and we were discussing, the merits of your front man's dancing. He's got a very unique style, and my friend described him as like Mick Jagger after about three pints of Red Bull. Do you think that's a fair description?
I think he's definitely got the look of a young Jagger, but I don't know where the hell he got those moves from at all. It's like overnight he developed, yeah.
So he didn't have them when you got together at 14?
Well, no, when we were doing our Green Day covers and that, he wasn't really slinking about the stage as much as he does now.
Ah. And do you sort of have to ever sort of stop yourself from having a little smirk at his expense? Because from a bloke's point of view, it's a bit like, well, but from the ladies love it, I know.
That's true. I don't know, even a few men have been licking their lips as well. I think it's hard not to admire it, I've got to say.
Yeah, he's definitely got a unique style. What's your dancing style like?
Pretty stiff, pretty wooden, Fortunately, I've got a guitar to hide behind, so I don't have to worry about such matters.
And that, another interview I have seen, you've been described as the gregarious member of the band. Get on with everyone. Is this true?
Well, I don't know. Not everyone. I certainly don't take a shine to racists
So the small-minded, narrow-minded, unpleasant people, but anyone besides
them? Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you have to, we're too good a position to be all arsey about everything.
So are you chuffed to be back here at Reading? I mean,
it's weird because this is like the first festival we came to as nippers and built our first plastic bottle fire at and did our first poppers at, and it's odd being on the other side of it all. I think I'd have a kind of 15-year-old me would be swearing at the likes of me now swanning around the guest bar.
Do you ever miss that element of coming to a festival?
Well, no, because I still do go to festivals. I always go to Bestival.
Are you going this year?
We didn't play it last year, but I still went as a punter, which was stupid because it was pissing it down. It was rubbish. But
yeah, I have to say, I didn't go and I was chuffed that it was raining.
Smart move.
But are you going this year?
Yeah, we are. We're playing on Friday, so we get the Saturday and Sunday to actually be actual guests at a festival.
And will you be dressing up?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. Yeah. I don't know what has yet. I've not planned my costume properly, but there's plenty of tinfoil, so yeah, I'll do that.
So, and what can we expect from your set today? Are you looking for all the people watching to really throw some shapes in the Ed Macfarlane style?
That would be incredible, yeah. I think we played a few gigs recently where people are just hiding behind their camera phones, taking pictures. You want them to actually experience it for themselves and, yeah, get into it, do some dancing. That would be fantastic.
Because I know that a lot of bands out there sort of just really concentrate on the music, but you're very much into putting your heart and soul into the performance.
I think they should go hand in hand. I don't think you can like focus on one too much and let the other one kind of lack in any way, but I think there are too many bands who just look good and sound shit, and too many bands who just sound shit and look shit.
Anyone in particular?
No, certainly not going to start flinging mud right now. Maybe at the end of the day when I can retreat back to the tour bus and drive off.
Now when you come to festivals like this, I noticed Florence from Florence and the Machine, you're clearly good mates. Is that what it's like? You know, you come together with a lot of other bands. Is it like just meeting up with old friends?
Yeah, it is. It's good when you come to all these things and, I don't know, there are actual familiar faces that you can kind of have a actual conversation with, you know, people you genuinely know rather than people you kind of recognize from afar from a certain magazine or whatever, and you don't really want to go and chat to them because you don't know what the fuck you'd say to them.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's good. It's nice to have someone, yeah, you can talk to about, I don't know, the dull touring circuit.
Is it dull at times?
No, I think it's dull kind of chatting about it, but it can be fun, it can be dull. Yeah, I don't know. It depends. It depends where you are. If you're touring Belgium, it's tough work.
Yeah.
But we just come back from South America, which is
a lot
easier on the air.
Yeah, I saw some of your stuff from like Buenos Aires, and was that pretty amazing?
It was incredible, yeah.
Have you been before?
Never ever, no. I'm so glad we got a chance to go and like let our music take us there as well. But I still feel like there's so much of it we haven't even nearly got a glimpse of.
Talking about touring, I mean, you do so much of it. Does at time become sort of laborious?
It does. Well, you've got so many times when you're in an airport queue, you're waiting to get through customs. Like, touring with all flight cases full of guitars isn't easy when you get to New York and they've got the strictest checks in the world. But when you're actually, I don't know, at the venue doing your show, that makes it all kind of, you know, makes all the queuing worthwhile.
Now, like you said, well, judging from the sun, three hours or so till you're on stage, do you have a specific way to sort of G yourself up, or I mean, do you get nervous, or is it pure excitement, or what?
I think that kind of hour and a half leading up to the gig, you just want to get on and do it. It's a mix of nerves and excitement, but more like there's nothing else to be done now. Let's just put it to bed. But then as soon as I get on there, it's like the most relaxing place to be.
Oh, really? So as soon as you're on, the adrenaline kicks in and it just feels totally
natural.
Yeah,
it just feels like, yeah, I know exactly what I'm supposed to be doing right now. As long as nothing messes up around me, then I'm good to go.
Any surprises or anything exciting we can look forward to in your set today?
No.
Any snapshots of something that perhaps no one else knows?
I don't know. We've got our horn section with us that a lot of people will have seen already, but hopefully the whole
point
of doing
your porn section?
Horn.
Sorry, I thought that sounded pretty out
there. That certainly would be newsworthy, but nothing so salacious.
Right, so just your horn section.
Yes, just the horn.
Now, I have to ask you, what is your favourite Friendly Fire song?
Right now, I've got to say I really like Kiss of Life, our new track, just because it's fresh blood.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And any of your older stuff?
I like playing White Diamonds live. I think they're kind of has a bit of a stirring mid-late that people seem to get into.
And just finally, what's the one that tends to really get everyone going most? Would you say it is Paris?
Paris, hands in the air, yeah, all the time. It's ridiculous. So people love that.
Any chance for, you know, a wave or something like that if I'm near the front?
If you tell me what position you'll be standing in, I'll aim it in your direction.
Just
definitely,
look for the pink t-shirt.
Okay. Well,
there's not many of them with red hair, I don't think. Anyway, listen, Ed, real pleasure to meet you. Hope that beer slips down nicely, and great luck with the set today.
Thank you. Have a good time, man.